Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hello everyone, welcome back to the PL-300 exam preparation series where we are exploring the first learning path, prepare the data. In this video, we will continue to explore the topic create and transform columns. In this video, we are going to look at two further transformations that we can do through the conditional column option and the custom column option available inside the Power Query editor. So now let's go to the Power Query editor and see how we can use both these options. So in the previous video, we explored the options to extract and merge different columns. And there we did not apply anything that was specific to a particular record. So whatever operation was being performed, we actually performed it on all the records. So now we are going to look at another case where there could be certain scenarios where you actually want to do something based on a condition. So here, if I look at my customer, there is a column which says total children. So we have a column which says total children, and in this column we have the age, we have the number of children who actually belong to that customer. So here, if you see, there are different numbers and there are few records here like this one where the number is zero, which means that this customer does not have any child. So based on the information in this column, I want to actually create a condition and I want to create a new column. And in that column, I just want to say that, okay, if the number of children is equal to zero, just put a capital N for that particular record. And for all the other values, whether it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, I just want to put Y. And I just want to give the name to this column as has children. So I want to create a new column that is actually looking at the records. And then based on the records, it is going to assign a capital N or a capital Y. So now let's see how we can do that. So again, the requirement is to actually create a new column and we do not want to actually transform this column. So straight away we are going to go in the add column option, and immediately below the add column option you see the option which says conditional column. So I'm just going to click on conditional column here, and it is going to now give me a preview window, which is the add conditional column window. And here it says add a conditional column that is computed from the other columns or values. So I want to give this a name. So like I said, I want to give it a name, has children. So this is the name of my column. And now this area, I am going to specify a condition. So normally the conditions are presented as if else scenarios. So I'm going to say if, and I'm going to go and look for my total children column, because that is the column which is going to be used for this conditional column. So I say if total children, this is the operator. So here I have multiple options, equal to, does not equal, greater than, less than, and so on and so forth. And then I'm going to say, okay, if total children equals zero, because this is my first condition, then go and output the value capital N. So this is my first condition, and whenever this isn't the case, so whenever the value is not zero, so obviously you can't have a negative value here, so it's going to be always a positive value. And for that case, I would say just go and put the value in the else column, which is Y. So if I just quickly recap this, so this is the whole condition where it says if the total children is equal to zero, just go and output capital N, and if this is not true, then just go and output capital Y. So this is going to create a new column, which is the has children column. So now I'm just going to click on OK, and now you can see that a new column has been created, which is the has children. And if you scroll down, this is the record where the number of children was actually zero. So these are the two records. So if I scroll on to the left, you can see that this is the one we are talking about. So now this is an example of how you can actually create a conditional column where you are not applying something on the entire column like we did for merging and extraction. We are actually going and looking at the value itself, the value of the record, and then based on the given logic and given condition, we are actually performing an operation, and we have created a new column just by using this option. So if I go back to the add column option here, just to show you something, that you can actually have multiple if statements. So if you have one if condition, if it is not meeting, then you can actually add use this add clause column, add clause option here, to actually have if else if. So you can have multiple if else ifs, and then finally you would have the else option here. So just spend some time playing around with this add conditional column option. Next, we are going to explore another option, which is the option to add a custom column. So like we just saw for a conditional column, we added a new column that worked on a condition. So the custom column option allows you to actually apply any mathematical function or any logical or mathematical function in the form of M script, and you can actually go and actually perform that. So in order to do that, first look at what we want to do. So we have a column here which says product retail price, and I want to create a new column that actually offers a discount on the retail price. So let's say if I want to have a 90% discount on the retail price, and I want the value as a discounted price in a new column. So that would mean that I would go and I would multiply all the values of my product retail price with 90%, which is 0.9, and I would get a new column which is going to be the discounted price. That is going to be the name of that column, and I'm going to see the discounted price for all those values. So in order to do that, we have to, again, because we want to create a new column, we are inside the add column option here. And then we have this option here which says custom column. So I'm just going to go and click on custom column here. And this is now going to open up a formula bar. So here you have two things. Again, the first thing is that you need to specify the name of the new column. So I'm going to give it the name discounted price. And here now I can write a custom formula. And the formula can be written using the columns which are available to me. So in this table, these are all the names of the columns which are available to me. And this is the area where I can write a formula. So I want to use my product retail price. So I can just either double click on this here, or I can just select and click on insert. It's going to have the same result. And now I am going to put the mathematical formula which says multiply by 0.9. So now you can see that there is also this text appearing in this area, which says that no syntax error have been detected. No syntax errors have been detected. So here we are using the custom column formula window option here. So now it is something that we haven't seen before. So here we can come, and if you want to perform any mathematical operation on a column or even a combination of columns, we can come here and we can create that formula. So if I go and click on OK, then you are going to see that this is a column that we get, which is the discounted price, and this value has been multiplied by 0.9. All these values have been multiplied by 0.9. So this is again another transformation where you can apply some kind of a mathematical function based on whatever the requirement, and you can actually build that formula and apply it to all the records inside your column. So that's the end of this video. So we actually looked at the conditional column option, and we looked at the custom column option. In the next video, we are going to look at the group by option, which is available inside the Power Query, and we will see how it can be used as a very important transformation step.